Hi, my name is Jason. My pronouns are he, him, and I'm a developer advocate at Slack. So now that you've got your functions in hand and added them to a workflow, the next step is to configure a trigger to kick off that workflow. Triggers are the entry point to run your workflows. By the end of this video, you'll know the four types of triggers, what consists of a trigger payload, how to create a link trigger, and how to run your workflow via a link trigger. Before we start, make sure that you have a workflow ready, as you need it for this section. If you haven't already created one, take a look at this video here. Let's dive in and take a look at what kinds of triggers there are. There are four types of triggers: link triggers, schedule triggers, event triggers, and webhook triggers. Let's go through each of these in detail. Link triggers are special URLs that unfurl within Slack to reveal a run button for your workflow. Schedule triggers are triggers that can be set to start a workflow at a specific time. Scheduled triggers can also be set to repeat, say every week or every month. Event triggers are triggers that start a workflow based on an event that happens within Slack, such as when a user joins a particular channel, or when a specified reaction is put on a message. Lastly, webhook triggers start workflows when a payload is sent to a specific webhook URL. If you're familiar with using webhooks to send messages into Slack, this is the same concept, except it will trigger a workflow instead. Here is an example of a trigger payload for a link trigger. This is where you'll specify the details for your trigger. Each key here plays an important part to the function of the trigger itself. The type key specifies the type of trigger that this trigger is, of the four that we mentioned earlier. The name key is the name of your trigger, and for link triggers, this will show up within Slack when the URL is posted into a channel. The description key is a description of your trigger, and this too will show up within Slack when the link trigger URL is unfurled. The workflow key is the callback ID of the workflow that you want to run when this trigger is executed. Lastly, the inputs key is an object that describes the inputs provided to the workflow. Once you have your trigger file written, you'll need to actually use the file to create a trigger within your dev or production environment. Triggers can be created through the CLI and at runtime through code. In this example, we'll be creating a trigger via the CLI. You can use the trigger command of the Slack CLI to create a trigger. Using the create subcommand and specifying your trigger file with the trigger def flag, you'll end up with a command that looks like this. Once you run this command, you'll need to choose the app that you want to add your trigger to. Note that you may see the name of your app with dev in brackets beside it. This is the development version of your app, which connects to your local computer via Slack RAM. If you want to add your trigger to your production app, make sure to choose the production version of your app and not this development version. If everything goes all right, you'll see some key information about your trigger, which confirms that it was created successfully. Now, you can copy and paste your shortcut URL in Slack, and it will unfurl, revealing a run button that you can use to kick off your workflow. Click this run button and you'll see your workflow run, and that's it. Now that you've created your first trigger, you now have the power to execute your workflows at will. Use this power wisely. The next step in our video series is a video on manifests. Click here to view. Otherwise, for more video content on the new Slack platform, take a look at the description box for a curated list of what you need to know. And don't forget to subscribe and like this video. See you in the next one.